howdy, pilgrims. This here's Dilakaba, and I'm here at White Hart Island about 7 a.m. I'm on the southern island. And, you know, lately we've been starting out by stopping in to see Mabel the Greeting Bear so that we can find out what she'd like us to add to the lodge. But this morning we're not going to do that because I'm hoping for a little surprise for Mabel. Now, I've got a mission that I've got to do, where I've got to take 4 white-tailed does with Buckshot in order to earn some GM. And I've also got a mission where I've got to take 4 Tom Turkeys with a .22 caliber pistol at a short range. And so I figured, well, we'd come on down here to White Hart because, well, it's got turkeys and it's got white tails and so on. But more importantly, there are Roosevelt elk here, and I'm hoping that in the course of our hunt today, I can come across a real nice Roosevelt elk so that we can redeem ourselves by getting Mabel a big old honking Roosevelt elk to put up on the wall. We'll see what happens. But let's take a look at what we got with us today. First of all, of course, I've got my Parker Python. I've got a few tracer arrows left over from a bundle I had gotten. I figure, well, we'll put them on there and shoot them up if we get the chance. We, of course, have our shotgun with our buckshot. And then we've got our .22 pistol here to deal with those turkeys if we should come across them. So we've also got our turkey box call and our turkey locator. And then, of course, we've got our elk call and our elk juice and our whitetail call and our whitetail juice. I'll show you where we're kind of figuring on going here. We're here at this Southern Lodge on White Hart. And what we're going to do is we're just going to work our way up to the first stand here. And we're going to come on up towards the second stand. And from there, we're probably going to make a beeline for the place where the islands come together, because usually they're in the reeds. That's a great place for some whitetail bucks, and we'll be passing some really good fields along the way. And I'm hoping somewhere along here we just may come across some good elk. This stand right here by these little ponds has been known to produce some very fine Roosevelt elk. What we're going to do is we're going to start out heading for that very first stand there. Let's get our sense presser on. And, you know, the hardest part about this hunt is going to be keeping me from getting distracted by whitetail bucks. It's a nice, easy marker. Slip on up here into the stand, and hopefully we'll get our first doe for this mission. Now get us a chance to just get out here and take a quick look. See if anybody else is out there. It doesn't look like it. Nope, doesn't look like it. But she should come along pretty cooperatively. The does tend to come in pretty quick and easy. They're very gregarious creatures. They like to be in herds in the real world. And they seem to reflect that, at least in terms of them being very responsive to calls and scent patches. But she wasn't out there very far, so we shouldn't have long to wait. Oh, we got a buck. Where's that feller? He is coming in from that side. We're going to go prone. And we're going to work our way right across here, nice and quiet-like. And see what we see. I told you, easily distracted. I think he could be coming into our call. Get a look at him. If he's a monarch of the forest, I'm not going to hesitate. We'll find other does. That's another one. We got all kinds of bucks out there this morning. It figures half the time I come here to White Hart, walk half the island, don't see a buck to save my life, and there's nothing but does this time around, because we've got to take does. There's going to be nothing but bucks. turn around. We're going to go prone, head back over where we can keep an eye on our patch. There's air coming in. In fact, I'm going to go prone. I'm going to move this way just a little bit. Make sure we got a clear shot. Check my scent suppressor. 20 minutes left on that. Well, he's moseyed up. He's trying to make up his mind. There he is. See, look at this fella. Well, I mean, he's a good-looking buck, but he's not. Oh, and there's our doe right there. Now I got a quandary, because on one hand, we can put that right in him and finish him on the spot if we get the right shot. There we go. And then take her with the shotgun. In the real world, this wouldn't happen. She'd smell blood. She wouldn't come close. Oh, we got another buck coming in. All right, we're going to hold tight. See where that fella is. He's right out over there. Good grief. He's coming in too. We might as well wait and see. Like I say, we get a big old monarch of the forest, that doe will have to wait. That's another doe. And we got that buck coming in. 7 a.m., my friends. She's actually pushing around the one we got down. Come on, buck, show yourself so I know whether I can take these does or not. Because if these does wander off, we can turn around and we can go down there and call him right back in again. Here he comes. I heard him walking. We can turn around, refresh our patch, call those does right back in again. See, he's right down there. Come on up here, pal. Let's see you. Yeah, it looks like he's not much one. I don't know, he's sporting a pretty good rack, all things considered. I'm sorry, that's just... Ah, lordy, you're in a pile. Land of Goshen. Now, you know, now if you took and you actually drug them and put them like that, that'd be one thing, but I mean, they're... geez. Now, question is where those does have gotten to. Okay, the ones out there. Well, we're going to go prone. Our scent suppression here. super good. I'm just going to slip up, see if we can spot one of these does here. See, I hear her, but I'm not sure where she is. If she'd just present, we'd take her. There she is. Step on out there, girly girl. There we go. That is just ridiculous. Shoulder blade, right lung, heart. That's what I was doing, was trying to take the heart shot on both of them. Drop them in the spot. There we go. Howdy, pilgrims. We are back here at Red Feather Falls at the Darkwood Lodge with part two of our attempt to get a surprise from Mabel the Greeter Bear. In our last episode, we went out to try to get Mabel, a lovely elk, to replace the little bitty fellow that we got on our first elk hunt to put one up in the Trophy Lodge. Well, we never even saw an elk. As a matter of fact, I went from the southern tip of White Hart Island all the way up to the northern tip and even up into the northern island. Never saw an elk. I did manage to complete my mission to take five does with buckshot. And I do have a mission to take a whitetail with my .44 pistol. So I got that with me today. But I thought today I'd do something different. I have not been using my longbow because, well, I just haven't shot it a lot, and I've always worked in my ghillie suit shooting that longbow. And so what we're going to do today is we're going to continue our effort to come up with a good Roosevelt elk to surprise Mabel the Greeter Bear. They're trotting, they're keeping a pretty good pace. Gonna have a little trouble keeping up with them, but we will close the gap. They'll slow down at some point. I got the fever now. I can feel it in my bones. Because as much as I love taking me a big old whitetail, I just as much love taking a great big old giant Roosevelt elk. And there he is. All right, you. Oh, he moved just before I could shoot. And I can't go prone here. Come on now. Boy, he's really giving us a dance, isn't he? Every time I get ready to pull the trigger, he shifts. That is him. Oh, he's gorgeous. All right, Mabel. No more little tiny elk on the wall for you. There we go, right there. Oh, look at this feller. Mabel will be pleased. That's what I'm talking about right there. All right. Let's collect him up. Beautiful shot. Got him in the lung, the heart, and the liver. There was no way he was walking away from that one. And can you believe he's only a 290? Zoom out a little bit. Make sure we can see them horns nice. And there we go. Good enough, except, yes, we are going to taxidermy this Roosevelt elk. All right, well, there you go. Now, we need us a whitetail. We need to take a whitetail with the 44. And to do that, we just may do some fast travel. We're going to get a look at the big map, see where we are. But by golly, we got Mabel her elk. I am really surprised that he only come out at 290, as nice as he was. But he's still a heck of a lot better than what we got up on the wall right now. And like I said, we'll keep trading him out and keep getting Mabel a bigger and bigger and bigger Roosevelt elk. But she should be pleased. Let's take a look at the map here and see where we are. We're actually up near that stand right there, huh? I'm kind of tempted. I'm kind of tempted to jump over to this location here and then work our way up this way for that whitetail. There's a moose up there, but I'd swear that I just heard a black bear. There he is, too. Look at that. Female, 40 to 140 kilograms. She's not real big. That moose wasn't looking too bad. Oh, and there's a whitetail buck right there. There he is. Check him out. He's not bad at all. All right, we're getting down off this rock. And we're going to give a call. See if we can pull this buck in. Let's see, right here. We're going to go prone. And see if we can pull him in. He's nothing to write home about. I mean, he's a nice buck. But biggest bummer is we got a moose over there, we got a bear to our left, and then we got a deer of some sort in the water out there. But what matters is us taking this fellow with the pistol. That's a running bear now. You keep running too, damn you. All right, let's go collect them up. And I'd love to hunt more, but by God, I'm excited to go back and surprise Mabel with this bear. With this bear? See, now I got bear on the brain. Surprise Mabel with this elk. I get charged by the black bears every time, so I'm not at all brokenhearted that this black bear got sent packing. Well, he's not a bad little fella. I mean, he's sporting 8 points. He's an 8-point buck. That's nothing to sneeze at. There we go. Heart, right lung, liver. I figured we could get the heart shot on him with that pistol laying on the ground like that. But he's just a 109. That's all right. We're not even going to bother with a trophy shot. And we're not going to taxidermy him. Because we are headed back to the lodge. To the lodge. Oop. Is that moose out there? He's still out there? Let's get a look. Yeah, there he is, by golly. He's not much of a moose. He's all right, but I don't think we're even going to bother with him. We're going to head back to the lodge. We are going to surprise Mabel with this Roosevelt elk. How you doing, Mabel? Well, that's good. Say, you like surprises? I got a little surprise for you. Check this out. What do you think, Mabel? Oh, yeah, he's a good-looking wolf, ain't he? Yeah, here to keep you company at the door, but I think you need to take a look to your right. I knew you'd like that one better. I know that other fellow was kind of small, and I promised you I'd get you a bigger Roosevelt elk for the wall. In fact, he even kind of matches up a bit with this other one. They're a lot closer now. So there you go, Mabel. I hope you and this feller here will get to know each other and become good friends. Let's see if we can make some adjustments here. Oh, there we go. Make him friendly looking. There he's down in a low crouch, looking one way, looking the other. There we go. I think that's, what do you think? All right, good. And old Gil, he still hasn't had anything to say. Still the strong, silent type. But there you go, Mabel. I felt bad that we brought you back that little bitty fella, and, well, I thought it was time that we remedied that. Now, he's not the last one. We're still going to come up with one bigger than him, but at least now I feel like I've maybe redeemed myself a little bit. And I just wish that I could have shown you and the folks the hunt for this wolf, but it ended up that I was not recording at the time that I got this fella. But, all right, Mabel, well, I got to get going here. I got things I got to do. Oh, I hate it when the real world gets in the way of my game plan. But I appreciate y'all joining me and sticking with me for this two-part adventure to get a surprise for Mabel. He's a good-looking elk, by golly, so I'm headed on out of here. But remember what Mabel the Greeter Bear and her boyfriend Gil always say. If you're going to be a bear, be a grizzly.